Well, we all know the mom or dad with the camera at the ready, always trying to capture every precious moment of their children's lives.
Well, not too many of those parents capture the attention of Time magazine. But Jesse Burke is no ordinary shutterbug, as Ted Reinstein discovered.
Just relax your face a little bit. There you go.
For Rhode Island photographer Jesse Burke, it's hard to separate his family from his art. That's because his three young daughters are so often his subjects. In 2016, in fact, his prolific snapshots of the lives of his girls prompted Time magazine to name Burke one of 50 must-follow U.S. photographers on Instagram.
It was just us living our life. And so we have gained some great traction through amazing outlets like Time magazine, New York Times, T magazine, for having a fun account to follow. So I'm very excited about that people like it.
To pay the bills, Burke shoots commercial jobs for all sorts of national magazines and companies. His specialty? Creating striking heroic portraits of often ordinary people. Affable, energetic, curious, Burke excels at getting subjects to relax, though he never knows what he's captured till the last shots are fired.
I feel like I know, and then I'm always wrong. I think the ones that often work the best are the ones where I didn't expect something to happen. The moment where they shine in their interaction with the scene or the experience or whatever's happening is out of my control. How do you know it's igneous?
Because it's shiny.
Burke grew up in a working-class neighborhood near Bridgeport, Connecticut. A pretty macho guy as a young adult, Burke always assumed he'd one day have a son and do all those guy things his dad never did. Now, he shares his home with an accomplished working wife and three very independent daughters.
If you had asked me what I wanted, I probably would have chosen otherwise, and I couldn't have been more wrong about what I needed and wanted. And so now I have this little like clan with these little warrior women running around, and my goal is to raise them to be strong, confident, brave women.
From the moment his older daughter Clover was born, Burke and his wife vowed to imbue their children with a love for nature. Today, their sprawling backyard, often a backdrop for his pictures, has 10 hens, a rabbit, geese, even a descented black skunk. No, we're not kidding.
She's a very loving, sweet animal. Doesn't
She's
stink at all.
She's very timid, though.
She's very shy. The newest member of the farm is a potbelly pig.
I got you. You're not gonna fall.
Named Goose. A little boy, he's 3 or 4 months old. It's not uncommon to come over and see the pig and the dog and the skunk sort of running around in the kitchen together. It's kind of crazy, but it's magical.
Clover, now 12, has grown up in front of a camera. Over the first 5 years of her life, daughter and dad took multiple road trips to pique her interest in the natural world.
I sit here listening to the crickets sing you to sleep and wonder if you're dreaming of salamanders or sunsets.
From those expeditions, Burke produced a touching movie and book called Wild and Precious, exploring his hopes and dreams for his firstborn.
I want you to trust the night air, to not be afraid of spiders, to know things that I don't. Essentially, it's a love letter, and I was very careful about every word so that when, you know, someday when she reads it, she'll realize the seriousness of it and the tone of it, how much I care about her, and then how much we together should care about the planet.
7 years later, Burke's limitless daughter pics can be seen on Instagram, where he now has 96,000 followers. He believes two factors are driving traffic to his page: increasing women's empowerment and growing concerns over the precarious state of the environment.
They feel connected to the land through my pictures, and then that instigates them to go get physically connected themselves, which is really exciting for me because it's just kind of a personal pursuit, and I never really intended to be sort of the Pied Piper in any way, but I love that that's happening.
Whether lensing photos for high-profile ad campaigns or snapping Instagrams on the fly, Burke says he relishes the same challenge, to tell a story through every image.
I feel so fortunate to be from New England with such a vast landscape of seasons, and to be a dad with three healthy kids and a beautiful wife that loves me, but then also now have my work and my personal life just become one thing. I wake up every day and I look out back and I think, I'm so lucky.
And so good. I mean, commercial advertising clients have really taken note of Jesse's work on Instagram.
They have. Just this month, a national dealer of recreational campers actually hired Jesse to take his family around Arizona for a week in a camper. And those images that he took from that trip are now going to be used in an upcoming ad campaign.
Wow.
I know.
Fun for everybody.
Fun for everyone.
Well, some called him the world's first paparazzi.
Put that camera in his pocket, sneak in.
Meet the man behind the iconic photos when Chronicle returns.